Later on, and right now, skiing. The men alpine skiers have been straining at the bit now for days, frustrated by the great blizzard of 84. Well, today they finally got their chance to do some racing. The event was giant slalom with both runs to be contested in one day, unlike the original two-day schedule. Reporting from Bialoznitsa, Frank Gifford and Bob Beatty.
You're looking down from Bialoznitsa towards Sarajevo, some 15 miles distant. And it's a beautiful day for the men's first alpine competition, the giant slalom. For almost a week now, Bialoznitsa, which translates to the White Mountain, has been lashed with unbelievably high winds and buried under heavy snow. Today, however, couldn't be a better day for a ski race. The sky is clear, the trees laden with new snow, the course is packed and is ready. This area was developed after Sarajevo was awarded the Olympics 4 years ago. Bialoznitsa will be used for recreational skiing after we're all gone. The two runs of the GS were scheduled for 2 days, but because of the weather, like yesterday's women's giant slalom, it will be compressed into 1 day. All the men's alpine events will take place here at Bialoznitsa. The downhill, postponed last Saturday, will go on Thursday. The men's slalom will take place on Sunday. Here, from across the valley, you can see the various courses that will be used. A large crowd has lined the nearly mile-long course here for the giant slalom. Many are Yugoslavian, and they have their best shot for the first Yugoslavian medal ever in the Winter Olympics with a couple of fine young racers. The Americans are also here, many of them still flushed and buzzing over yesterday's great effort by our U.S. women in the women's giant slalom.
Hello again, everyone. I'm Frank Gifford, standing at the finish line of the men's giant slalom with my partner, Bob Beatty. We are almost here. We might have celebrated a little last night, that gold and silver by Debbie Armstrong and Kristen Cooper. And I tell you, you can put on a celebration, Beats.
Well, we had double reason to celebrate. It was worth it.
Okay, we're getting ready for the men's giant slalom, their first alpine event. And here we are in Bialoznitsa, and we have seen it like really southern Siberia most of the time we've been here. It's been a tremendous snowfall, but now the sun is out. What's it done to the course, Bob?
Well, the good thing, Frank, is that they've really been able to clear all of this snow off. The reason why is that the course is very steep, so they've been able to just kind of slide it off to the side. There's been about 3 feet of snowfall, so they had really their work cut out for them. They've done a good job. The course is in great shape.
They'll ski the snow off and get down to the hard ice?
Well, it's pretty icy, but more than that, it's just good, firm snow. I think that really what this hill does, though, being so steep, unlike the women's giant slalom that we saw yesterday, which was relatively flat and could kind of favor somebody who just went and attacked, you're going to really have to ski well. It's going to favor the people who are technically good skiers. And I think that's going to make an interesting element to this race.
Okay, two of the great ones in the world are not here. Ingemar Stenmark, who's won 3 of the 4 giant slaloms this year, is not eligible for the Olympics. He took that B license out after Lake Placid. That made him ineligible. Mark Girardelli, who's been skiing for Luxembourg, he is not here. So that should help the mayors, Bob.
Well, I think the thing that really helps the mayors, of course, having those two racers that you mentioned who are very good not being here, it takes two of the top ones out of the competition. But really, the thing that's going to help them most here is the fact that they really ski so well. They're very good technically. And that is, as I've said, going to be very important.
Yugoslavians, we'll hear some woofing, barking, bells, and all that, because they have a couple of good giant slalom skiers.
Well, you know, they've never won a medal in the Winter Olympics, and this is their best chance. The men's giant slalom really is where they have 4 good ski racers. I think particularly Yuri Franco and Krizhai are going to be the best of those, but there are a lot of Yugoslavians come up to see if they can do just that.
Okay, and from Switzerland, the only other winner in giant slalom competition this year, Max Uhlen, is also here. We're just about ready for the start of the men's first alpine event of these Winter Olympics.
And moments away from the start of the first men's alpine competition of these Olympics, the men's giant slalom. Let's take a look at the start list. The top 15 racers are seated in one bracket based on their performances in the GS over the year. They each draw for a start position, while the rest of the field follows in the order of their performances over the year. And Joel Gaspeau of Switzerland has drawn the number one position. He'll leave the start house, a 21-year-old Swiss racer and a good one. We saw him at the age of 17 up at Lake Placid. We saw him again in Schladming, Austria for the World Championships in 1982. Great performance there, finishing 4th. He's been off it a little bit, Bob, but we know he's a tough little racer.
Well, he's a good one and a great prospect. You know, he's been on the Swiss team since he was 14. 1982, you mentioned Placid. Well, he also finished 5th in the overall World Cup there. But then all of a sudden, something happened to him last year. He ended up all the way down in 76th overall position. Well, I'll tell you one thing. The Swiss have taken care of training for this particular season. They trained all summer long on glaciers in Switzerland. Then they did dry land training in September and October, and then right back on the glaciers in November. They are prepared, I think, don't you?
I believe they are, and we're watching Joel Gaspeau. He's very slight of frame, not heavy, short, and that could help him on this short, Bob.
Well, the gates are set very quick together, very close together. He's a good little skier, and it's very steep down through here. Ordinarily, Giant Slalom favors a bigger, stronger man where they're rolling and flatter hills, but not this one.
And as he comes down through the lower part of the course really steepens. And as you can see, even though we've had that big snowfall, this course is really rock hard.
Well, he was popping his turns pretty well up on the top part. He seems to be a little bit more tentative down here at the bottom, though.
Here's Joel Gaspeau moving through those final gates.
Well, he really is tentative down through here instead of really attacking, which he should be doing.
Down to the top, stripping the electronic timing device. First race it down the board, 21.98. And Joel Gaspeau will have to wait to see how he fared. The racer really doesn't know quite how they have done until other racers come down the course. And Joel Gaspeau will find out in a moment. Now in the start house, Andreas Wenzel of Liechtenstein, just finishing the Giant Slalom this year, is a 10th place. He's had three top 10 finishes in the slalom. Bob, we saw him win the silver medal in Lake Placid in GS. Good all-around skier, good competitor.
And a good start position for him, starting right up near the top where the snow is in good condition. Also, this is a very good hill for him. We can see how quick he is getting off of his skis right through here. By being a good hill, I mean a small ski racer who is also good in slalom, which Wenzel is, obviously is quick and can turn well, should really be favored here.
That's his running time on the ride. As you can see, Joel Gaspeau was a little faster up on the top than Andreas Wenzel.
Okay, we really don't get a total feel for how steep it is from this picture right here. It is extremely steep, though.
And with all the snow we've had, it obviously has blown hard up here. They clock winds up to almost 120 miles per hour. That's almost unbelievable. The snow fell, a lot of it, but it apparently is, most of it has blown off. This is really hard. You can hear Wenzel carving those edges.
Well, the one thing that we can see in his skiing back and forth across the hill, it's a relatively tight giant slalom. Of course, by that I mean quick turns back and forth on this very steep hill down through here. And the thing is, he's got to be able to keep his weight really over his downhill ski, not lean in at all. You can see him get a little bit off him right there and time those turns. You don't want to stay in your turn too long. We get almost lost him. He almost set on his inside ski.
Gaspeau's time on the left and Wenzel on the right, and he has replaced Gaspeau as the leader. Andreas Wenzel picked up time on the bottom. Oh, good, strong, steady veteran racer from Liechtenstein.
Very good on the bottom part of the course, Frank. He really skied well down here.
Andreas Wenzel, he has the lead after two races coming down. He had one win early in the season, not in giant slalom. That was in the slalom. Here's Austria's Franz Gruber, a veteran racer. He's 25 years old. No top 10 finishes in the giant slalom thus far this year, but he's done very well in the slalom. He's been in the top 10 six times there, and that ability, the technical ability, Bob, could help him on this course with the tight gates.
Well, just as we have seen Andreas Wenzel come down, a good slalom racer, and do well here, now all of a sudden here comes Gruber, who's also a slalom specialist, really. Not that good in giant slalom. The thing about the Austrians in general is that they've been great in downhills, we know, with Palmer and all the rest of that great Austrian team. But in the last few years in slalom and giant slalom, they have really been weak. As a matter of fact, Gruber here in 1983 in Grand Gregory, Yugoslavia, became the first Austrian to win a slalom in 5 years, if you can remember that.
And they don't like it over in Austria. You saw Gruber up at the top of the hill. He replaced the time of Andy Wenzel up there. He's in the fastest racer down, the third racer down. He has the best time up at the top.
And Frank, this whole mountain is really a sheet of ice. Before the snow came, this was all watered down and iced up. And I'll tell you, it is really hard underneath this soft layer of new snow.
And now Gruber is moving through that part of the course that is really dicey. It gets very steep down here. And as you can see, it is icy. One little mistake and you can be off the course so quickly.
Gruber caught his arm just a little bit on a pole.
Wenzel is the leader. You see his time come up on the left. The running time of Gruber on the right. That's Wenzel's time on the left, and here comes
Gruber.
He'll be close, but no, he does not overtake Wenzel, and he moves into second place. So right now, we have Gaspeau in third place, Gruber, and then Wenzel. There he is, the leader. The veteran racer from Liechtenstein, his sister, Hanni Wenzel. She is not here. She could not compete in these Olympics. That'll be a story for later.